Today, we are going to look at how we can create the housing surrounding the fan of the Arctic Freezer 50. Before we go into this tutorial, it might be a good idea to go to the product page, take a look at the product pictures, and think about how you might approach this. To preface this video, I want to say that this is not intended to be an exact replica. As such, I will be putting less emphasis on dimensions and more emphasis on the creation of the general shape. I have taken the liberty to simplify certain features for the sake of clarity. I will not be going through the steps of inserting the canvas. It is not necessary to do so in order to follow this tutorial. I would urge all viewers to simply open a sketch and just sketch out a rough shape to follow along. Accuracy is not important here. Rather, the focus should be on understanding the workflow and the commands involved. It is always a good idea to start off by identifying planes of symmetry. In this case, there are two. The plan here is to create a quadrant and then mirror it twice. Before we consider more advanced techniques, we should always ask ourselves whether it is possible to create a simple extrude from a simple profile and then cut down to the final shape. The answer is yes in this case. Let's create a profile on the front plane. Let's draw a center line from the origin and set it to construction. I will use a picture as a guide to trace out the shape. Again, I want to emphasize that you can still follow along without the use of the picture. Just a rough shape will do. If you look at the pictures closely, you will notice that this surface is at a slight taper. For the sake of simplicity, I will model this as a flat face. Also, we will ignore this recess for the moment and just draw a straight line across. We will be cutting out the recess later. Close out the sketch profile along the center line. Let's extrude this out. If we look normal to the right plane, notice how that there is a taper on this face. If we set a taper angle in extrude, notice how all the faces surrounding the profile get tapered. In our case, we only want this face to be tapered. For that, we need to use a draft command. Let's remove the taper and confirm. Go to Modify, Draft. Select Fixed Plane as a type. For pull direction, select this face. This will serve as a neutral face, meaning that the draft will not affect the dimensions of this face. Next, select the face to be drafted. Adjust the angle and confirm. Now, we need to address this recess. Let's sketch out the recess on this face. And do a simple extruded cut all the way through to see how that looks. Comparing this to the pictures, this doesn't look right. The lines are parallel on our model, while the lines in the picture are converging. Converging lines usually hint at the loft with a changing cross-section. Let's delete the extrude. The existing sketch will serve as the starting profile of the loft. We will need to sketch the ending profile on this face. Turn on wireframe display so that we can take reference from the vertical edge of the starting profile. We will need to adjust this line in a way that creates the converging lines that we see. Let's leave it undefined for the moment so that we can easily adjust it. Go to Create, Loft. select the two profiles. Because these two profiles share the same number of vertices, the loft command will join them in a way that makes sense, eliminating the need for rails. Let's confirm the loft. At this point, you can compare the model with the pictures to see if the converging lines match up. If adjustment is needed, turn on visibility of the sketch. Without going into the sketch, you can drag and adjust the profile, and the loft would adjust in real time. After this is done, go back into the sketches to define it fully. Looking at the pictures, there's a small cutout at the top. Let's sketch a cutting profile on this face. Take note that we should not be using this face to sketch the profile, since that is tapered. We will be sketching half of the profile here. Select the profile and create a true all cut. Again, you can adjust the profile to match the picture. Next, let's tackle these offset faces. One way to do that is to start a sketch on each of these two faces, create offset lines from the edges, use the sketch to perform a split face, and finally use the press pull or offset face command. That would involve quite a few steps. An easier way would be to create an offset surface from the top and use it as a cutting tool. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Offset. Select all the top faces. Set an offset distance and confirm. Go to the Bodies folder, hide the solid body to take a look at the surface body. We shall use this surface body to create split lines on these two faces. Go to Modify, Split Face. For faces to split, select these two faces. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select the surface body. Because some of the top surfaces are at an angle, the offset surface does not fully cut through the entire solid body in some areas. So we would want to extend the splitting tool. This option would extrapolate the surface for us to ensure that the surface cuts through the body fully. Confirm and hide the surface body. If we look at the front view, you can see that the offset does not extend all the way to the middle. We will need to create another split line. Start a sketch on this face. And use that sketch to split this face. Activate the Solid tab. Go to Modify, Offset Face. Select these two faces and set an offset. The last feature to be added would be the center hole for the fan. Instead of creating a quadrant of the hole, it would be easier to perform the mirror first. Go to Create, Mirror. For Type, select Bodies and select the body as the object. For Mirror Plane, you can choose either of these two faces. The order does not matter here, as you will need to perform the mirror again across the other face. For operation, select Join. Repeat the mirror across this face. Finally, perform the circular cut. From here, you can proceed to shell and add details. The main purpose of this tutorial is to create the general shape of this design. This is not intended to be an exact replica. So hopefully, I've captured the design intent here and done the original design justice.